Hey everyone, it's Ben Hardy here, and in today's video, we're going to be going over a 2020 Dodge Durango in the SXT trim package. So, as always, a huge shout out and thank you to the Dodge Ram here in Sandy, Utah for providing us with the Durango SXT. Check out the return link below. Let's just get right into it. Now, under the hood of the SXT Durango, we have a 3.6 liter V6. It goes through an 8-speed automatic transmission. Fuel economy is 18 around town and then 25 on the highway, with power outputs being 293 horsepower and then 260 pound-feet of torque and a 0 to 60 time of about 7.4 seconds. Now let's go over the front end on the SXT Durango. So the hood is pretty much the same as any other Durango. You will note that you do get halogen projector bulbs up front, and then this doesn't have those cool like LED lines that the more upgraded Durangos have. Still get fog lights down there at the little bottom portion, and then you get Dodge's signature kind of like chrome crossbar at the front. But yeah, I mean, they keep things pretty simple at the front end, and that's all. Coming around the side here, we've got 265 millimeter tires on 18 inch rims in the front and in the rear as well. And then here is just a quick look inside the wheel well. It's, well, at least what you guys can kind of see. Plastic fender flares on the side, then they kind of do some chrome trim just down along, and then plastic fender flares in the back as well. But there is your side view on the SXT Durango. Here's the key fob on the Durango. You have a couple functions. You've got the unlock, the lock, Dodge logo on the back, and well, that's it. There is no remote start or anything like that. And the rear hatch is also hydraulic in nature, so just pick it up. You don't have any automated system for that. Now, coming into this part of the rear, you get a little bit of extra storage just underneath this little part right here. Little storage cubby right there on the side. You have a little 12 volt charging station right here, and then the seat, you actually just have to pick up this loop and that picks up the third row. Pretty simple to do, and then you can just put that little tab and then push it forward to do the third row again, just kind of throw it back down. When you are all done with the rear, you just have to grab here, which doesn't work the best, so I recommend grabbing on the outside, throw it back down. Now, finishing things up with the back, you get the full LED light strip here in the rear Durango, the dash 4 sign as well. And other than that, I mean, it looks like a Durango. They keep things simple, and let's not spend too much time here. Now, coming here into the back of the Durango, they actually do give you leather with some stitching all across, and then there's kind of like this metal trim just right there on the side. Here are the seats in the rear. So it is full cloth seats with the SXT Durango. Now, you can get captain chairs, but they come standard with a bench seat here in the back. And then there are your little cup holders. Now, in terms of legroom in the third row, we'll just flip that seat down so you guys can kind of see. Legroom in here is a little bit cramped, so I kind of reserve the third row for kids. The second row, you can comfortably fit adults. And then if you're wondering on that function, you just have to pull that tab, and that'll like lower the seat down and all that. But that's that part of the rear. Now, if we go over here, notice that you do get a couple of vents in the back, and the climate controls are up here at the top on the ceiling. So it does have a rear climate as well. And well, that's all. Coming to the front, we do get keyless entry, which is pretty easy to use. Now, here is the door panel on the front. Notice material-wise, it's identical to what is in the rear. You got your window controls, mirror controls, all that kind of stuff, pretty normal. And then here is the seat in the front. Same material as what's in the back, just the bolsters are a little bit larger. You've got adjustments on the seat. Now, they are fully manually adjustable. There's no power adjustments. You've got the pedal layout there at the bottom, and then you've got your little light control right here, and then the steering wheel is also manually adjustable. Now, to start up the Durango, foot on the brake, push the push start, and well, that'll pop on, and that'll pop on. Here's the steering wheel in the SXT Durango. You've got the cruise control on this side. You've got the controls for the little center stack on that side. Your phone controls all down below. And then you got stitching on the inside of the steering wheel. It's a little bit grippier on that part. You got smooth leather on the top and on the bottom as well. You've got the stock for the windshield wiper on that side. That also doubles as the turn signal stock. And well, that's all for the steering wheel. Now, here is the little gauge cluster. So you've got RPMs over on the left side, and then right there in the center, you've got the little configurable aspect of it. Notice that the speed kind of went to a smaller size. You guys can remember that the Grand Cherokee I reviewed last week did the same exact thing with the gauge cluster. Now, here's the center infotainment system. Notice this is the smaller unit. First off, there's the backup camera, so you guys can see resolution on it, and then also the little trajectory lines. Now, with the rest of the infotainment system, this has the same functionality basically as the 8.4 inch, it's just smaller. You actually can fold the headrest in the rear, so if I press the button, boom, headrest will fold down. Pretty simple, whack the kids in the back of the head, and then you can also control the climate controls from here. Remember, it does have a tri-zone climate, so two different climate zones up front and then one for the rear. Again, response time is good, and it's all for the infotainment system. Here is the analog controls. You got the analog controls for the volume and rest of the radio controls. You've got the dual zone climate controls, and then you have the stability control right here. So with the drive modes, some people get confused with the stuff on the Durango. So right now I'm in the eco mode. If I press eco mode off, that's technically normal mode. And then if I press sport mode on, then that is the sport mode. So you do have pretty much three different driving modes, and then you can turn off the auto stop start if you don't like that function. Got a couple of USBs down here and then a little 12 volt as well. Here's the shifter for that 8-speed automatic, and it does have a manual shift mode if you want, so you just put it over there and then you can shift the gears yourself. There are no paddles, they're just rocker panels on the back of the steering wheel to do the radio stations, just no gear shifting there. Couple of cup holders. Here's the center console. Notice that you've got a little top storage and you can lift it up. There is a 12 volt charger just down below. And finally, we've got the glove box all lined with felt. You've got the nice trim up here at the top, and that's all for that part. Up here at the top of the Durango, you've got the little controls for the lights. Now you can get a sunroof even in the SXT, but it's just like a regular sunroof. There is no panoramic sunroof option available for the Durangos at all. And then it is a lighter colored headliner. Now that we're done going over the interior on this SXT Durango, this one also has all-wheel drive, by the way. Let's quickly go over pricing. So this one stickers for about $35,500. So, I mean, yeah, that's actually pretty inexpensive for a larger third-row SUV that has about 6,000 pounds in towing capacity. And that all being said, let's take this SXT out and see how she drives. Let's talk about visibility here in this SXT Durango before we set off. So there's your visibility over the hood. There's what it looks like through both of the mirrors. And then here's what visibility looks like throughout the rest of the rear. Now the headrests do get in the way, so it's nice you do have that headrest fold if you don't have people in that third row. It'd be cool if it folded down the second row too, just saying. But that all being said, let's take the Durango out. We are setting off here in the 2020 Dodge Durango SXT, and a big reason why I actually wanted to review this was the fact that I just wanted to basically review like an entry level third row SUV like the Durango. It's supposed to be kind of more in like a, I guess like a price point vehicle, right? It's not gonna have like all the crazy bells and whistles that a more loaded up Durango will have, but it still has a lot of the same utility. And first off, with the ride quality on the SXT Durango, I mean, it rides just like all the other ones. I will say that like the RT and the SRT, definitely because of their sportier suspension, ride just slightly rougher than this. This is a little bit smoother, so this will be the same as the GT as well in terms of ride quality, then also the Citadel. Now with the steering, extremely light and effortless. Now with the directness, there is a little bit of vagueness. I would put it on average for an SUV in this segment in terms of the vagueness. But I mean, it's a good steering rack in general. Pretty, again, pretty much on par with where it should be in this segment. And we're gonna get kind of like our mild acceleration here. Just like, probably like half throttle is what I'd call it. And the transmission's really responsive. The V6 is an okay amount of power for this, but now we're going to get our full-blown acceleration once this minivan's done making a U-turn, and we will see how that goes. Jeez, that Grand Caravan though. Okay. So it, again, because this doesn't have a ton of power, it does take a second to actually get through the gears itself, because it takes a second to get the vehicle up and moving. The power is adequate, but I wouldn't call this a fast vehicle by any stretch of the imagination. And just continuing along here, today it's extremely windy. You guys probably noticed that in certain parts of the video with, I mean, both cameras, right? Just freaking wind is going crazy today. And the cabin's really well insulated. Not a lot of that wind noise is actually making it through into the cabin itself, which I think that is a huge plus. And I guess we'll get into summing things up. So I really like this SXT Durango as an entry-level option for like just a really good utility vehicle. The towing capacity on this is about 6,200 pounds. It is a 7-passenger vehicle, and I mean, it's under $40,000. Now, again, it doesn't have a ton of nice creature comforts other than the 3-zone climate. That being said, though, again, it has so much utility, and for how expensive cars are nowadays, the average new car price is about $38,000. So this is below the average new car price for the MSRP, and it's a third-row SUV that tows over 6,000 pounds. So I think it's a really good value. But yeah, I would still definitely look into one of these SXT Durangos if you just want a good utility vehicle that is pretty simple on the inside and isn't gonna break the bank. And there we have it, everyone, the 2020 Dodge Durango SXT with all-wheel drive. And again, a huge shout out and thank you to the Dodge Ram here in Sandy for providing us with this Durango. Check out their inventory in the link below. I will see all of you in that next video.